In this quick video, we're going to have a look at using rubber stamps with leather. Now, ordinarily, when we stamp leather, we think about stamping leather. We're talking about using metal stamps and we're either doing borders and things, or we're doing basket weave, or with tooling and making designs and patterns and things. But you can use ordinary rubber stamps that you would use with paper or card with your leather quite effectively. So we'll have a little look and see what we need, what kind of results we'll get in case it's something that you're interested in having a go at yourself. So, why would you want to have a go at using rubber stamps with leather? Well, there's a few different reasons. Obviously, it gives you a slightly different sort of appearance to normal. When you stamp your leather, in terms of getting some definition into that, obviously you can use the antique gels or you can brush and dye and so on, but it often doesn't give you a sort of very crisp look. It's more looks like part of the leather as such. If you use a rubber stamp, then you're going to sort of put a design very much on top of the leather, and that'll give you a slightly different look to the end product. So it's kind of a style thing that you could choose to do. Obviously, there's a large variety of rubber stamps available. Rubber stamping and card making is a hobby in itself. You know, people enjoy making birthday cards and things like that. So there's a huge range of rubber stamps that you can buy, and you might not necessarily be able to find those in a leather stamp. Now, they're not a direct replacement for each other, obviously. But if you think, oh, I really want the design of a particular thing, you can't find it in a leather stamp, you might be able to find it in a rubber stamp. So it gives you that bit of variety there as well. Obviously they're inexpensive, so it's not an expensive thing to try at all. If you wanted to make some things with children who you maybe they wouldn't be confident obviously hammering leather stamps, because maybe too dangerous for younger children in terms of them sort of hitting themselves and so on, they could certainly have a go at rubber stamping without sort of causing themselves any injuries. So there's all different reasons why you might want to try. So what do we need? We don't need much at all. We need some rubber stamps and we need some ink. Now the rubber stamps, they're all pretty much the same. They're all made the same way, so you can buy whatever stamps you want. I've got just a little jaunty thing to have a go with here. And then you need some ink. Now, in terms of the ink, I think really that's going to be one of the major things, is that you need something that's going to hold fast on the leather. So obviously your ordinary leather dye is designed to penetrate the leather, it's designed to dye leather. Ordinary ink, which you would use for rubber stamping, isn't designed for leather as such. So there's a couple of things you could do. You could get an empty ink pad and try and charge it with some leather dye and use that. That may have a tendency to bleed a little bit into the leather. I haven't tried that because I didn't think that was the best approach. But what I managed to get is some of this archival ink, and that's designed to be a very permanent ink. It's the kind of thing that you would use to stamp an official document or something. So it's designed not to fade and run and be a very permanent solution. So I think that's probably the best compromise, but you could certainly experiment with different things. So I've got a piece of leather here, and this is going to be turned into a nice notebook cover, and I'm going to stamp this stamp onto the notebook cover. Now, I think it's going to be best to do the stamping before you do anything else with the leather, so that the obviously the ink is getting onto the leather surface, and anything that you put on top of that, like additional dyes, additional finishes, sealers and things, that's all going over the top of the ink, and that's only going to serve to keep that nice and locked in, and stop it smudging or running or anything like that. So I wouldn't dye the leather and then try and stamp on top of the dye if you can avoid it, and I certainly wouldn't try and stamp on top of any finishes. So you want to know exactly where you're going on your design, because it's not like a metal stamp where you can put it down and adjust it and twist it a little bit and get it just right and then hit it with the hammer. If you charge this with ink, as soon as you touch that down, that's going to mark that piece of leather, and if you do it wrong, you're basically going to be making a lot of black notebook covers, because you're going to have to dye the whole thing. So I need to work out exactly where on my piece of leather I want to put this stamp down once it's charged. Once I'm happy with where I've got that positioned, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my square. I'm going to lay my square against the edge that I've drawn here, and I'm going to flush that with the bottom of the stamp there. And I can leave that in place, can weight that down, and then I know exactly where that needs to be, and all I need to worry about doing then is getting the middle lined up. Now, it depends what you're stamping as to how accurately you want to line it up as well. Obviously, if it was just something like a small flower or something like that that you were dotting around, you could quite easily just dab that down. But for something like this, where it needs to obviously sit fairly central, you want to take some time to get that lined up nicely. This is a black ink pad. Of course, you can get all different colours of ink pads as well if you wanted. You know, blue, red, green, whatever you wanted. You could certainly get a few different ones. Black is probably going to be best for some sort of text like this. So once I'm happy that that's all charged, I now need to do the stamping. And as I said, this is going to be the tricky bit with something like this, because if you put it down and move it, it's going to smudge. If you put it down kind of twice, you're going to get a double impression. Once I've got it down, without moving it, I'm just going to make sure I apply a little bit of pressure, give it a slight rock to make sure all the lettering gets on there, and then I'm going to lift it straight up. There we go. And there we are, that's that stamped. It's as easy as that. As you can see, that's covered quite nicely. I won't film me making the whole notebook. You've seen these notebooks before, but I will show you the end product of the notebook, just so you can see what this looks like. And when I put the dye over this as well, because it's not going to be left natural, I don't want to use too dark of a dye, because it's going to swallow that text up. So I'll use a fairly light brown, and that'll give me some nice contrast in there. Obviously, don't forget to clean your stamps once you've done the stamping as well, otherwise when you use a different colour, you'll get a right mess. So I'll clean this off, and then I can get to dyeing my leather. So to dye the leather, to make sure it's not too dark for going over the top of there, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take some light brown dye, which as anybody will know isn't that light once you get it on, and I'm going to put a little bit of dye reducer in it as well. So okay, now I'm going to sponge that on. I'll just work that until that's nice and even. Don't worry about the fact that it looks dark at the moment, it's because it's wet. Anyway, that's all I'm going to do with it. I'm not bothered about it looking super even, because it's going to add to the style of the thing if it's not, you know, completely flat. As I say, it looks a little bit wet now. I'll give this a couple of hours and that'll fade down to a nice lighter colour. Okay, I'm going to get this cleaned out. If you ever mix any dye up like that, and you've got a little bit left, you want to call that a bit of light brown or something, you can buy little pots, you can tip it in a little pot and use it another day, it's fine, it'll stay and sit mixed like that. There we are, that's the item all finished. I think that's turned out quite nicely. So if that's something that you want to try, you should have all the information that you need there to give it a go. It's nothing complicated about it. Obviously this style of thing isn't going to be for everybody, but just bear in mind there are an awful lot of subscribers on the channel, so I'm trying to get something for everybody into the videos. Okay, thanks for watching.